2016 East Coast low, there was an existing rock wall here and it was destroyed. So Soil Conservation Service were brought in to remove that redundant wall, and we are building a geotextile sandbag structure to replace it. Its main purpose is to protect the from erosion behind, protect the campground assets and some big Northfolk pines. The Cronulla Soil Conservation Service team did a similar project down at Bonnievale for national parks, and so they've then engaged us again to do this seawall here. I think we did a pretty good job down there and try and carry that through here. At the lagoon, the Basin campground, there's a big deposit of sand. It's sort of come through the longshore drift along the coast and deposited there. So we've basically harvested all our sand from that area, transported it over to our site here. That sand is then used to fill the geotextile bags, and which are then used to build the wall.
Yeah, working with the tide, it reduces the amount of time that we can actually work during the day. Everyone's hands on in that period to get everything done. The laying of the bags, and because we're below sea level, we're still working in water in the bottom, in the tow bags, which, you know, presents a problem, but we're the specialists, so that's why we're here doing it.
An extremely labour-intensive project, so we've got a lot of marine grade geotextile that goes underneath each of the bags. So as soon as that gets wet, which it naturally does once we're working in below the mean sea level, it's just extremely heavy. So at times it's been really difficult. It's been all hands on board to sort of, you know, to actually work with it and get a nice smooth profile. That's been one of the biggest challenges. The actual sandbags themselves, filling them is quite labour intensive also. So, you know, we have the machines to fill the bags, but, you know, they often get clogged and things like that. So that's actually, yeah, it's quite time consuming to actually get all our machines down here. They had to be dropped off at the top and we had to track them all down, which took, you know, over an hour to get in. So that's been fine, but it's just a bit of a sort of delay on the project. And we've also got a lot of campers around here, more so toward the end of the week. So all of our vehicle movements have to be super slow through here. So all of those are considerations that have been a part of the project, but we just, site safety and public safety is the most important thing. So we've just taken it all nice and slow when we're around the public, and that's really all we can do there.
SES was brought in to do the job. Primarily, the old school thinking was laying rocks along the beach, which it still presents a scour problem. The new way of doing it is with the sandbags, the large sandbags, which allow the water to dissipate its energy by sliding up the beach instead of crashing into hard-faced rocks. In the long run, the beach will be much better. It'll be more family friendly. It's easier to have your kids sitting on these bags than sitting on rocks. People can walk down to the beach a lot easier. It's even easier for me. I won't break my ankle walking down over the rocks. So the bags do, they do help in a lot of ways.
In general, I think we'll find that the campground users will really appreciate them as just that extra little bit of amenity, and that's part of what the client wanted and part of the sort of desire to have these sandbag structures as opposed to a traditional rock seawall.